Hey everybody! So last week, Hyperdimension Neptunia U Action Unleashed was released exclusively on the Vita, and I'm here to tell you whether or not it's worth your money. Here are my thoughts.
Developed by Tamsoft, the same studio behind the Senran Kagura series, and published by Compileheart, Hyperdimension Neptunia U Action Unleashed is the latest spin-off in the long-running franchise to be released on the PlayStation Vita. While other spin-offs in the series have tackled genres such as idle simulators or strategy RPGs, Action Unleashed is a Musou-style third-person hack-and-slash title very much in the same vein as other titles from Tamsoft. Much like the other spin-offs, the story takes place in a parallel timeline outside of the main universe, so those unfamiliar with the events of the previous games will still be able to jump in and enjoy without much backstory needed. In it, game industry journalist Dengeki Go and Famitsu are writing articles on the adventures of the CPUs and CPU candidates for their respective magazines. When the first article takes off in popularity, there's a sudden increase in quest requests, so Dengeki Go and Famitsu decide to join in the fight as their way of writing the perfect follow-up to their original articles. Things seem to be going fairly smoothly, but the increase in monster activity and a few irregular quests with no descriptions start to make the team wonder if there's maybe someone or something else pulling the strings. In terms of plot, it's actually fairly thin. Outside of a few character-based quests, city events, and cutscenes that bookend the prologue in three chapters, there's really not a whole lot to go on. The plot is merely a means to an end, rather than an all-encompassing, sweeping narrative to drive you to finish the game. That's not to say it's bad, as most of the jokes and references are actually really quite funny, and the dialogue between characters in battle and in the menu system is entertaining as well. It's just that there's not a lot there. It's meant to jump you straight into the action rather than bog you down with endless amounts of plot, which is understandable given the name of the game, so going in with the right expectations is key if you want to enjoy the game. Speaking of the action, your enjoyment of the gameplay will depend heavily on how much you enjoy Musou-style games. If you're a fan of Senran Kagura, the Warrior franchise, or Tuikoden, then you'll probably feel right at home playing this game. But if you find these games repetitive or boring, then chances are this isn't the game for you. Outside of the irregular quests, which require you to perform a special task in order to complete it, most missions boil down to killing a certain amount of enemies or killing a certain amount of enemies and then the boss at the end. It's inherently repetitive, but each of the 10 playable characters play wildly different from one another, and experimenting with various combinations of characters can lead to some really interesting results. There's a deep layer of strategy to how you approach each mission, because certain characters work better in certain environments, and utilizing their abilities and special moves can really help or hinder you going into battle. The clothes-tearing mechanic, which happens if you get hit too many times or use strong attacks too often, also adds another layer of strategy, because it can help give you that extra boost if you feel like you're getting too close to death. Once you beat the story mode, which will take you anywhere from 10 to 12 hours depending on your skill level, there's exclusive bonus missions and a tower mode where you take on waves of enemies as you rise up the ranks. There's also the game news events and the medal system, which unlock certain items, weapons, and buffs depending on your actions in battle or how many of a certain enemy you kill, so there's plenty of incentive to keep going once you've beaten the main game. In terms of presentation, it's about what you'd expect from a Neptunia game. The sprites are bright and colorful, the game runs smoothly with little to no frame rate drops, and the soundtrack is catchy and enjoyable, though most of the songs are recycled from previous entries in the series. The only real problem with the presentation is the constant loading screens. Most of them only last about 5 to 10 seconds, and some feature profiles on the characters, but they happen with enough consistency that after a while it gets a bit tiresome. Otherwise though, it's a good-looking game that runs smooth as silk. In the end, while Action Unleashed may not have the deepest story and the mission variety leaves a lot to be desired, the fun and engaging combat kept me entertained throughout the campaign and well into the bonus features, and fans of the series are bound to enjoy this game quite a bit. It may not appeal to everybody, but for those looking to have some fun hacking and slashing their way through endless hordes of enemies, you could really do a lot worse.
So what are your thoughts on the game? Have you had a chance to play it yet? What's your favorite video game spin-off? Be sure to leave a comment below letting me know what you think, but as always, be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share this video with whoever you want. And until then, I'll see you next time.